and I have six electrons over here, and I have zero electrons over here. Okay, so now when I was defining a transition element can form one or more stable ions of variable oxidation states with an incomplete D subshell. So if you look at this ion of Fe, if you look at the Fe2 plus ion, we have an incomplete D subshell because we can still fill four electrons over here. It's not completely filled. We can have a maximum of 10 electrons in this entire subshell, but we have only 6, so it's partially filled, it's not complete, and therefore this completes the definition of a transition element. Now let's take the example of Fe3+, the other ion that that iron forms. So we have We have Fe3+. So again, I'll only make the 3D and 4S subshells because that's what we are concerned with. So this is my 3D subshell first. And this is my 4S subshell. So 3D, 4S, and Fe3+ is basically this Fe2+ ion losing one more electron. So if you look at the electronic configuration of Fe2+ again, then we have 6 electrons over here and 0 electrons over here. Now, to form Fe3+, this loses one more electron. So if you remember, this electron was the one we filled last. So this will empty first. So we will have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, 0 electrons here, only 5 electrons in the 3D subshell because it lost this electron. The Fe2+ ion lost this electron to form the Fe3+ ion. And now if you notice, we again have a partially, an incomplete D subshell, a partially filled D subshell. So we also have variable oxidation states. So Fe2+, Fe3+, two different oxidation states. This has an oxidation state of +2. This has an oxidation state of +3. And they have an incomplete D subshell. So yes, Fe does fill the criteria for a transition element because it has formed one or more stable ions of variable oxidation states with an incomplete D subshell. So this is basically the definition of transition elements, and I have explained this to you. And before we move further in the chapter, I want to do another recap with you of chromium and copper, the two exceptions, because now that I've explained the role of 4s and 3d to you, I want you to know that chromium and copper's outermost electronic configuration does not really, its electrons don't really fill the way they are supposed to. So I'll tell you why. I think I can't erase this, so I'm going to make it over here. So chromium has an atomic number of 24, and as you can see, all this adds up to 18. So I'm not concerned with this part till 3p6. I'm still not concerned with it. I have 18 electrons here, so for 24 I need 6 more. And as we know, if we look at the conventional state of affairs, now just let me make the 3D and 4S subshells. Okay, I'm sorry, I was about to make an extra. Okay, so this is 3D, this is 4S. Okay, so we need to fill 6 electrons in these two subshells. So what we already know is that this will fill first 2 electrons, and then we have 1, 2, 3, 4. So the problem with this is that we have an empty orbital in the 3D subshell, and we have a completely filled